Land use change analysis and its role in RACP. The land use change analysis, also known as LUCA, is the main tool used to determine growers' liabilities for non-compliant land clearance in the remediation and compensation procedure. This video is the first of two that will provide an overview of LUCA and the key time periods as part of this analysis. LUCA is required for all management units with non-compliant land clearance. These liabilities will be identified and calculated using a matrix that takes into account the land cover of the cleared area since November 2005. This matrix will be explained further in the next LUCA video. LUCA will help determine remediation needs and compensation liabilities for all land cleared without prior HCV assessment after November 2005 by identifying three things. 1. Areas that need remediation efforts. 2. Areas with potential loss of environmental HCVs. 3. Areas with potential loss of social HCVs for affected communities. All clearance that occurred prior to HCV assessment will be categorized according to 1. Time period of land clearance. In analyzing the land use change, growers must categorize all clearance that occurred prior to HCV assessment according to these periods. Period 1, November 2005 to November 2007, when the RSPOP&C was being trialed. Period 2, November 2007 to the 31st of December 2009, when the first RSPO certificate was issued and before the introduction of the new planting procedure in 2010. Period 3, the 1st of January 2010 to the 9th of May 2014. NPP was introduced and before the staged implementation of the RACP. Period 4, from the 9th of May 2014 onwards, RACP was introduced. Early cases of non-compliant land clearance carry less compensation liability than more recent cases. 2. RSPO membership status of the grower controlling the land and any changes of its status during the period of liability. Members who joined RSPO earlier are expected to be better informed about RSPO's requirements than non-members, and as such, will face higher compensation liability if there was land clearance without first undertaking a HCV assessment. 3. Whether the clearance was for corporate or non-corporate purposes. Growers are not liable for non-corporate clearance, such as government projects that involve public works, or clearance by individual community members to support their livelihoods carried out without funding from an institution or organization. 4. Vegetation status in November 2005. A coefficient will be assigned based on the type of vegetation. The coefficient will be used in the calculation of the conservation liability, and this will be explained in the next LUCA video. 5. Lastly, areas identified requiring environmental remediation. Findings of LUCA and other supporting documents and maps should be submitted to the RSPO Secretariat for verification by an external GIS specialist. A summary of these will be made public later on as part of the summary of the compensation plan.